Hi guys, thank you all for tuning in and welcome back to Sewing Lara. In today's tutorial, I will show you how I created this cute witch hat. This is such a classical piece. I always wanted to have a witch hat like that with a band and with a buckle. So I thought this should not be missing on my channel. So I will show you how to make the hat and I will also go over how I made the costume that I'm wearing with the hat in this video. For the costume, I used the sewing pattern for my pumpkin costume. That's available on my homepage and you will find there also the sewing pattern for this hat in multiple sizes. So I will link everything down below. And now let's jump right into this. So if you want to know how to make this witch hat and how to make the matching costume, then please keep watching. Let's have a look at the hat parts first. So here we have the hat brim. It's two pieces made of velvet. I have ironed on the wrong sides of both pieces, very thick iron-on interfacing to make it stiffer. Then we have here the hat top, also made of velvet. It has also the thick iron-on interfacing on the wrong side. Then here we have the lining. These two pieces of black faux leather are for the hat band, and then we have here two pieces for the buckle, and I simply placed on the top a wire. We will need a wire for the outer edge of the brim so that the hat would not fall in. As a first step, I will take the hat tops. I will fold them in middle so that the right side will be inside. And I will start pinning this loose edge in place at an angle. And now I will go to my sewing machine and sew this together with a simple straight stitch. I will leave a little section open on the lining because I will need that later in order to be able to turn the head to the right side. Now that the side is sewn in, I have to chop back this point so that the pointy end will be nicely shaped once I will be done. So I will cut it very closely to the end of the seam, but I will make sure that I don't cut through the seam. And now I will turn this to the right side. And with the end of a painting brush, I will also shape the pointy end. As a next step, I will grab the hat brim. I will turn it over so that the wrong side is facing up. And I will place the hat top inside. So I will make sure that the right sides are facing each other. And I will start pinning it in place at an angle. When I'm pinning the hat top in, I always make sure that I align it nicely with the edge of the brim. And I move in really short distance over the edge because this is rounded. And what I don't want is that here at the other side it would create ruffles. So it's always best to have only about an inch between the pins. That's what works for me personally the best. Then I always get the best result. Here is what it looks like. I will go to my sewing machine and I will sew in from the inside with straight stitch. I will make sure that I keep the same distance from the edge. And occasionally I will turn to this side to make sure that everything is smooth. All right, so this is what it looks like once the hat top has been sewn in. I've done the same with the lining and now we have to put the pieces together and sew around the hat brim. I'm gonna get the piece with the lining. I'm gonna turn the lining to the wrong side and I'm gonna pull it over the hat. And I will start pinning the outer edge of the hat brim in place. This is what it looks like. I'm gonna sew around the edge with straight stitch. All right, so I have sewn around the edge. Now I will grab my zigzag scissors and I will cut back the seam allowance. I'll be cutting pretty close to the seam. And now I have to turn the head to the right side. For that I will be using the opening here. So I will grab one side, preferably the completely opposite side of the brim, and I will slowly start pushing the head through. Now I have to shape the edge, so you can just roll the fabric back and forth. I personally like also grabbing a pin and pulling a little bit at the seam, because that always helps me to shape it as nicely as possible. And I'll do it, of course, around the entire edge. Here is what the head looks like so far, and now I have here the wire. What I want is I want to place in the wire and place it really closely to the edge so that it will make the head brim stable, because now when I would lift it, it would just fall in like so. Here is how I'm gonna place in the wire. So first I placed pins around the edge. The distance from the edge is a bit over an inch, I would say like 1.5 inches. And now I will go in with one end of the wire. You can bend it slightly. And I will place it inside of the head first. And then I'll reach inside with my hand. And I'm holding in my hand here the end of the wire. And I will pull the wire behind one of the pins, so that it's close to the edge. And now I will start moving the wire inside so that I would move in the entire length. And I have to shape it also a little bit because I bent it a little bit in order to be able to go in. And that's how I'm gonna place it around the entire edge. You just have to take time with that and maybe reach over somewhere between other pins. And again, like, shape the wire a little bit, move it behind the pins close to the edge, and then more of the wire will disappear inside of the head. And continue doing so till the wire is completely in. And once you have the entire wire in, move it very closely towards the edge and put in a pin so that it will stay in place. But make sure that you pin from the side on which you want to be sewing. And I want to be sewing from the right side, so I'm going to turn the head like so. All right. And I will place the pin in at an angle. Now the wire has been pinned in place, and when I lift the head, see, everything remains stable and nice, nothing sags in. So the next step is to go to my sewing machine, and I have to sew really closely to the edge. You have to be very careful so that your needle doesn't hit the wire. You may even want to use the zipper foot. So here is how I'm sewing the wire in. So I took my zipper foot, I placed it on the left side of the edge, and I'm sewing quite close to this outer edge, but far enough so that my needle wouldn't hit the wire. And I'm taking my time. I'm always adjusting everything before I move further and making sure that the wire is close to the edge. Here is what our head looks like. I put in a few pins around the edge where the top of the head has been sewn onto the brim. I pinned together both layers of the brim, and I want to stitch them together right where the edge is, where the seam is, only on 3 or 4 places. That's enough. When you want to do that, you have to smoothen the brim nicely and then simply put a pin somewhere, and that's where you can make a few stitches. Also put a pin here, so this is holding the lining to the velvet, and I'll make a few stitches here as well. And when I'll be done, I will also close this opening on the lining of the top of the hat, and I'll do that here with a letter stitch. And here I'll just make a few whip stitches. One more place where you want to make a few stitches, and that's here right where the ends of the wire are. The wire is inside of the tunnel that we created by sewing around the edge, but these two ends have a tendency to kind of slide in like so, like what I'm doing with my index fingers. And because that way, when the wire slides in a little bit, it makes the circumference of the wire smaller, that would make the edge a little bit uneven, but you want the edge to be perfectly straight and neat. So what you want to do is go in where the ends of the wire are, push them a little bit further apart, and then you want to put a pin here, and that's where you want to create a few stitches. You can make a few back stitches, for example. Basically, what you want to do is to close the tunnel between the two ends of the wire so that they would stay in place, and that way the edge of your hat will remain neat. Now let's work on the buckle and on the headband. So the headband are two layers of black faux leather. I have sewn them together around the long edges, and then I grabbed my zigzag scissors and I cut the edge teeny tiny little bit back. I just wanted to have the effect that the zigzag scissors create. That is, of course, entirely up to you. Important is that you make sure that the edge is neat. So if you don't like the way this looks, just grab regular scissors and cut back anything that's uneven. And the buckle consists of two layers of golden faux leather. I'm not going to be sewing these two pieces together. I'll be gluing them together with hot glue because I want this to appear to be metal. And that wouldn't be the case if I had a seam anywhere. And you can clearly see that I cut around the edge also with zigzag scissors. I even made the edges a little bit rounded. So I already turned on my glue gun. So first, I'll glue these two layers together. Be very careful with hot glue, it gets really hot. You don't want to burn yourself. And I will also glue these two ends together. So I will make sure that the zigzag pattern is nicely aligned. As I was gluing the pieces together, I pushed a little bit of the hot glue out, but that's okay. I will shortly wait till it gets cool enough, and then I can align the zigzag parts of my scissors with the zigzag pattern on the buckle, and then later here, and simply cut the hot glue away. And now I want to grab the buckle and glue it so that it would cover the place where the ends of the headband come together. And here is what it looks like. And the last step for the hat is to place the buckle on the hat, and I can also glue it in place with hot glue on a few places. Alright, so now that we finished the witch hat, we can start working on the costume. I have used the same stretchy velvet that stretches only sideways. It's super inexpensive and I find it actually very pretty. The sewing pattern that I have used for the costume is the same sewing pattern I have used for my pumpkin costume. So if you remember, this is what the top looked like. And here we have the puffy skirt. I made a few minor alterations, so let's go over that. Here we have all the parts for the top. So on the left side, we have the back part. This is the front part. This is the lining that will also serve as an integrated bra. And for that, I have here this elastic band. And here on the right side, we have the sleeves. So it's exactly the same pattern that I have used for the top for my pumpkin costume. Only since the pumpkin costume top was sectioned, the upper part was green and the bottom part was orange, I had to align the pattern pieces accordingly because this top will be made of one piece. And the other difference is that I'm not going to be sewing the lining to the bottom sections. Instead of that, there will be an elastic band on the bottom, and that's why it's going to be also serving as an integrated bra, which is a great option, especially if you don't want to wear a bra underneath this top, but you still need the support. Let me show you quickly how to align the pattern pieces. So you have to make sure that these lines here are aligned exactly. And the easiest way to do that is to fold on one piece the seam allowance away, and then you simply place it on the other piece like so. And this way you will have a whole pattern piece for our project. And here's what the top looks like when it's finished from the right side. And this is what it looks on the wrong side. So instead of sewing the bottom of the lining to the main parts, I have sewn on an elastic band and then I have folded it inwards. And then I have sewn through with stretches zigzag. This is exactly the same way I did it when I made my razorback tank top. I will link the video here in the right corner and also in the video description. And I have for you a quick tip how to put this top on without becoming insane, because you get tangled between the main part and the elastic band of the bra, which happens to me very often also with sports tops that have integrated sports bra. I personally like pulling the main part of the top over the elastic like so before I put it on. And then I simply put it on as a sports bra, and when the thing is on, only then I pull this back downwards, and I find that much easier. Again, this helps me not just with this top, but also with my sports tops. Here we have the skirt. I used exactly the same sewing pattern that I have used for my pumpkin skirt, and I made it practically exactly the same way. There was one little difference, and that was when I did the shirring on the individual skirt sections. On the pumpkin skirt, when I was sewing the skirt sections together, I had shirring elastic on my bobbin, and that created this effect. For this skirt, instead of doing that, I have simply grabbed an elastic band and I have been sewing it on each seam with zigzag while I was pulling slightly on the elastic band, and that's what ruffled the skirt like so. You just have to be careful. Don't pull too much on the elastic band when you're sewing the skirt sections together. Otherwise, the skirt would shrink and would end up being too short. Alrighty, so that's how I created this cute hat. I'm definitely gonna have a lot of fun with this. One thing you could do, if you like the way it looks when the hat is bent, you can simply put your hand inside and squeeze it into any position that looks good to you. And then you can secure it on the inside with a safety pin. That's the easiest way, because if you change your mind, you simply remove the pin and the hat is going to be straight again. If you really like it, you can of course make inside a few stitches. And I actually really like the way it looks because it reminds me of the sorting hat from Harry Potter. There are two more things I wanted to say about the wire that I have used for my hat. So I used a wire that's really thick and strong. You don't need a wire that's that thick. I simply used whatever I had at home, but if I had to buy it, I would buy any wire that's a little bit thinner than 1 millimeter or maximum 1 millimeter. That's more than enough. And what you can do before you put the wire in, you can grab your hot glue gun and put a small amount on each end so that the wire would not be so sharp on the ends, because over time what would happen would be that the wire could start pinching through the fabric the same way it happens with bras that have a wire. But that is going to be it for today. I hope that you guys enjoyed today's tutorial. More tutorials are coming. I'm already planning some winter DIYs and some new fashion DIYs, so make sure you subscribe. You can also give this video a thumb up if you enjoyed it and share it. That supports the channel. And as mentioned, these sewing patterns are available on my homepage. Link is down below. So thank you all so much for watching. I wish you a very happy Halloween. I appreciate you guys so much. God bless you, and see you soon with my next project. Bye!